We have a success story from Team 8. I work in substance abuse, and we have a real success story with an addict. And I was sitting there thinking about, well, how am I going to tell this story? How should I lay it out for this guy? And I'll just look at it maybe like a timeline. In September-ish 2009, this guy was sitting in a jail. I think he weighed about 150, 160 pounds. He was using anywhere from 100 to 130 pills a day. Opiates, benzos, and amphetamines. He's sitting in jail, detoxing, hopeless. He had no job. He had no relationship with his family. His marriage was barely hanging on. He was charged with, at that time, I think, 84 felonies they had on him. The DEA had stepped in. And I think a judge had given him a break and said to this guy, he's like, you're either going to federal prison for 10 or 15 years, or you need to find a 90 days treatment. So he found 90 days treatment, and he said something just kind of clicked for him. He kind of figured out he had been an addict for about 12 years. He went to treatment, got out on Christmas Day, 2010. They let him out early because his nephew was killed in a four-wheeler accident. And he says that he went home, and he's participating in his nephew's funeral. He's 18 years old. And he said he's sitting on the front row of this funeral. His nephew's sitting 6 feet from him. And he said his overall emotion or feeling was gratitude rather than resentment, sadness, and rage for losing his nephew. And he says at that point he knew something had changed in his thinking. Then he got involved in the 12 steps. He started helping people. He started going to meetings. He got a sponsor. Started speaking at meetings and colleges. And I think the gist was that he embraced the fact that he was an addict for the purposes of helping other people. Because he had addicts that had helped him, and he had seen them, that there was a solution to his problem. So he finds out that there's a program offered at a little school in Logan, a two-year certificate program for addiction counseling, I think it was. And he got into that, he got involved, and he met some people from Logan Mingo, as it turns out. And then he found out about a bachelor's degree program that was offered at Lindsey Wilson. So I think I'll do that. So he gets involved in this bachelor's degree program. All the while, he gets a job as a tech at a rehab in Logan. So he works as a tech for about a year and a half. Got his bachelor's degree, and they hired him as a counselor. So I think he worked as a counselor for about 6 months. And his boss retired, and then they made him program manager. All the while, he's working on his master's degree, which I think he'll finish sometime this December. During all this time, he stays active in the recovery community. His marriage is healed, his family is healed. He actually became, he went from a pariah to everybody that knew him, to somebody that these people weren't around. He didn't talk to his family, I think, for over a year. Because of his addiction, because of the sickness. And now they want him around, actually. They go to this guy when they want to plan like a family function, birthday party, go on trips or whatever. It's crazy, the changes that he's experienced. And as a result of his recovery, he's become a father, happy husband, son, brother, all those things. And all this happened, well, for a lot of reasons, I think, for him. But it's like Graham was saying, the people in this room, if we do our jobs well, we create these success stories. See, this is a success story because here on May 15th, this addict is standing in this room telling his story.